Imagine a Honda CR-V with two hydrogen tanks in the back, an intelligent power unit positioned underneath the seats, and a fuel cell system and drive unit fitted as a single unit underneath the hood. Are you excited? And so, let's find out how Honda will make this happen. The next hydrogen-powered vehicle from Honda will be a plug-in variant of the new CR-V. The Clarity fuel cell, the company's previous hydrogen car, was retired in 2021, and the manufacturer began discussing this replacement vehicle last year. As of now, the image surrounding the powertrain is beginning to clear up a bit. Honda declared in 2022 that its CR-V-based next-generation fuel cell vehicle would be available for purchase in 2024 in North America and Japan. The fuel cell technology for the hydrogen-powered SUV was co-developed with GM. It will have two hydrogen tanks in the back, an intelligent power unit under the seats, and a fuel cell system and drive unit positioned as a single unit under the front hood. The plug-in portion of the equation's battery won't be able to power the CR-V for very far, and it appears to be so small that it didn't earn a spot on Honda's sketchy depiction of the forthcoming car. The hydrogen CR-V, according to Honda, will also be able to export power. Honda has not yet confirmed if the new hydrogen CR-V would be made available outside of California, the only state where the Clarity fuel cell is currently available for lease. However, Honda has confirmed that production of the fuel cell CR-V will start at Ohio's Performance Manufacturing Center in 2024, including cars that will be exported to Japan. Honda continues to be tight-lipped about additional information surrounding the car itself. However, last week it did make an announcement about the CR-V's next-generation fuel system. According to Ryan Hardy, senior manager and division leader of the Energy Solution Business Division at American Honda Motor Company, the new system is significantly faster to start up at extremely low temperatures below 22 degrees Fahrenheit and is more than twice as durable. Likewise, the next-generation technology is two-thirds less expensive to construct than the fuel cell system found in the long-gone Clarity, according to Hardy. The reason for the significant decrease is due to changes in the materials used, such as the use of innovative materials for the electrodes and production requirements, as well as a strategy to simply produce more units. By 2025, the fuel cell system manufacturing center in Michigan, which is jointly owned by Honda and GM, will be able to produce about 2,000 units of Honda's next-generation fuel cell system annually. A beta fuel cell system or this unit will be produced at a rate of 60,000 units annually by Honda by the year 2030. The future generation system will be considerably more potent and reasonably priced, although Honda has not yet disclosed any manufacturing or development partners. GM is not necessarily involved. Honda stated that it does not just aim to install fuel cell systems in cars, but also sees them as key participants in a society without carbon emissions. The automaker is looking for collaborators to test them in construction equipment, stationary power plants, and commercial cars. According to Hardy, Honda is actively looking for partners to collaborate on fuel cell commercial trucks in North America. With Dongfeng Motors, Honda is now testing hydrogen trucks in China. With Isuzu, testing will begin in Japan before April 2024. Honda will start selling its fuel cell technology to partners in the transportation and industrial sectors in the middle of the 2020s. And so, while we're waiting for this, let's check out the newly released 2023 Honda CR-V. In order to compete in the fiercely competitive compact SUV category, the 2023 Honda CR-V debuts with a completely new exterior and interior design. The new CR-V has already made an impression on us with its larger proportions and increased passenger room. Its inside features an appealing design that was influenced by the Civic compact car and modern technology, including an infotainment system with a wireless 9.0-inch touchscreen that supports Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, completes the look. Obviously, each CR-V also comes with a wide range of standard driver assistance features, such as adaptive cruise control, blind spot monitoring, and lane-keeping assistance. An optional 204-horsepower hybrid drivetrain is available, with a 190-horsepower Turbo 4 as the standard engine. No matter which engine you choose, the CRV offers a pleasant ride and confident, if not very exciting, driving manners. Both may be coupled with front or all-wheel drive. The 2023 CRV marks the start of the compact SUV's sixth generation. It comes with a plethora of enhancements, including a larger overall size, new external appearance, and a roomier interior with a more polished design and nicer features. Honda claims that the basic turbo 4 engine has been returned to be more responsive and efficient, and that its continuously variable automatic transmission CVT and all-wheel drive system have been enhanced compared to the previous models. Honda has simplified the CRV selection for 2023, reducing it to 5 trim levels. The LX, EX, and EXL are all gas-only vehicles. The Sport Hybrid and Sport Touring Hybrid are the only models with a hybrid powertrain, and they are the ones we'd suggest the most. The CRV Hybrid Sport with front-wheel drive is appealing. It has a low starting price of $33,695 and an EPA estimate 43 miles per gallon in the city, which beats the Toyota RAV4 Hybrid city rating, as well as elegant black exterior elements, black 18-inch wheels, and a leather-wrapped steering wheel. The Sport Touring Hybrid is more expensive, but it includes all-wheel drive and a slew of luxury extras that significantly improve the driving experience. The CRV's vertical grille conceals a standard 190-horsepower turbocharged 1.5-liter four-cylinder engine. It is available with a CVT and front or all-wheel drive. This configuration is standard on the LX, EX, and EXL versions. The Sport and Sport Touring models only have the hybrid powertrain, which combines a 2.0-liter four-cylinder engine with two electric motors for a total of 204 horsepower. While the Sport is available with either front or all-wheel drive, the Sport Touring comes standard with all-wheel drive. The Sport Touring Hybrid accelerated to 60 miles per hour in 7.9 seconds. All CRV trims have hill descent control, which helps to adjust the compact SUV's speed when traveling at low speeds on steep or slippery drops. The majority of variants come with 18-inch wheels, with the Sport getting black ones. The Sport Touring receives special black 19-inch wheels. For the first time, hybrid cars are rated to tow 1,000 pounds. While it lacks the handling thrills of the Mazda CX-50 and Volkswagen Tiguan, the new CRV provides a nice ride with just enough moxie to keep it from being dull. Powertrain options for the CRV include a 190-horsepower 1.5-liter gas engine and a 204-horsepower hybrid unit consisting of a 2.0-liter and two electric motors. The front-wheel drive CRV with a turbocharged 1.5-liter four-cylinder gets 28 miles per gallon city and 34 miles per gallon highway according to the EPA, whereas the front-wheel drive Sport Hybrid gets 43 miles per gallon city and 36 miles per gallon highway. And the all-wheel drive Sport Touring Hybrid registered 31 miles per gallon city and 75 miles per hour highway fuel economy route. The CRV's attractive interior design is accented by a honeycomb textured inlay that spans the majority of the dash and conceals the air vents. The steering wheel frames a partially digital gauge cluster with an analog speedometer and a 7.0-inch display that allows the driver to switch between several informational menus. Honda claims that the front seats are meant to reduce driver fatigue on long trips and that the driving position of the new CRV has been enhanced. A spacious center console bin sits between the front seat occupants and reclining back seats with an extra 0.6-inch of rear legroom compared to the current CRV. With the movable load floor in its lowest setting, there is 36 cubic feet of cargo capacity behind the second row and 39 cubic feet on gas-only vehicles. Having said that, did you love what you just saw? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. And if you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.